Whoops, I was still muted. So, welcome everybody to the Go Champions League Season 3. It's time for Group A with Hellraisers and Space Soldiers going tit for tat tonight on Inferno. The players are currently joining the server and I already gave you a small idea of what we are to expect. Hellraisers should win this game 10 out of 10 times, but you have an X factor in Space Soldiers. You have Xenteris around, we have strong all performances as well. And the Turkish squad is nowhere, they are scary sometimes. So let's see how they will perform tonight against Hellraisers. Currently waiting for the ready. Questone having some fun here with his teammates. So five players on the server. What are we waiting for? It's probably the odd guy that has to go to the toilet just shortly before the game starts. And for everyone that doesn't know, left mouse button, right. No, LMB, yeah, that's left mouse button. I will show you his profile so we all know who he is. Oh, he's fake nicking quite a lot. So, we should have everyone on the server. And yes, I have received a lot of questions about this radar. It's a simple radar because Valve decided to use a new one. And the new one isn't really too beautiful. So I wonder where Oscar is still. Just waiting. There he is, finally. So, Hellraisers against Space Soldiers on Inferno. I already said that the map is quite easy to play on the CT side if you have the right economy. If you fail to get the economy started at the start of the game, you will have a rough time on the CT side. Doesn't matter how one-sided it is, it can still get back and bite you in the back. And yeah, I just read the message where somebody said, well, please give us some more hope. We have a lot of Turkish viewers in the chat at the moment and on the channel. Yeah, I don't want to fool you, you know, because otherwise it's like, oh, damn that caster. He gave us wrong hopes. Hellraisers will probably have a better time on the CT side. They have enough skill around their team to plug the B-bomb side and at the same time handling the A side. Space Soldiers really need Xenteris to be on point tonight, just like every other day as well. If he performs, he can open up the bomb sites rather quickly with some good frags on the terrorist side. But let's see how they will do on the CT side, because they start on that side and we have Despi already getting the first frag onto Oscar. So that's one of the most important parts of Hellraisers taken out in this pistol. Won't stop the CAS squad from getting in front of the B-bomb site, getting into position and getting ready for that bomb push. Tugux tries to help Engine out with his flash grenade, but it didn't result in any frag so far. The terrorists will push construction site together. Good team play by Hellraisers, making it a 4v3 already. In the CTs with a quick rotation, but Despi gets dinged by Angel, and he picks up a USP to have some additional firepower. Already takes Xenteris down to 15 HP and just prevails, getting another and another one onto Paz. Good job by Angel holding down that retake by the CTs. 4 kills for him. Hellraiser start the terrorist side like anyone would like to start the terrorist side, with a pistol round in the back, so they have the chance to make it 3-0 early on in this game. And if they win the rifle round, they could also make it 5-0, and a 5-0 is the mandatory amount of rounds that you would like to get on the board. But we don't want to count the CTs out yet. We have Xenteris with a Deagle and the 5-7 in the apartments. Doesn't get the frag yet. Now he's getting pushed as well. Does a lot of damage, but it's not enough for any frags. Deku is down to 22 HP. Oscar tries to cover his teammates who push the A side together. And Questone is already on the heels of the CTs, getting himself some additional money with that MP7 spray. And Tugux and Despi are the last CTs remaining. The 5-7 for Despi doesn't give him too much to work with, especially now that Angel intercepted him from behind. Spacesuiters will not do too much damage in this round. Only one casualty suffered on the Hellraiser squad. And Space Soldiers with another save. This time nobody has purchased it. Well, as I say, Despi gets himself a P250, but that's all they have. Some good striving here. But it won't help him to get any frags as of yet. Angel's there. Close quarter fight with the AK. Easy pickings, but Tugux shuts him down with the USP. Angel got a little lost there on the spray, just kept waving his mouse around a little bit. And this time around, the CTs do some good damage, sadly, for Despi and Tugux. The aim punch is a little bit too much to handle, and Hellraisers get the 3-0 lead. So, Paz and company with the first rifle round. The orb in play already for Oscar. Hellraisers know how important that weapon is for him. And he can have massive impact in any game against any team. With not only the orb, but also with a rifle. But he's more known for his orping prowess. The CTs go for the default playing style. No aggressiveness on Banana either. And no peeks into apartments. Paz is holding it passively. He doesn't have any equipment, but he has an M4A4, and that could give him a fighting chance against the majority of the Xenteris push. Good crossfire with Xenteris. Paz chimed in with his own frag and closed out Oscar, making it a 1v5, and Stiku is on his own. He's got the AWP picked up, but the CTs are already all around apartments. They will not let him escape with that weapon. It's going to be a good boost for the CT's economy if they get that AWP saved as well. So they really want to salvage their weapon. Stiko on the other side wants to make it as expensive as possible to get it out of his hands, or impossible to be picked up, and it's not going to be picked up anymore. He was killed quite far away from the CT's, and due to the shorter amount of time at the end of a round, Spacesuiters couldn't reach the AWP anymore. So they stick with their 5 rifles they saved. And the terrorists with the first real buy this time around. They have 4 AKs and an AWP for Oscar. So no troubles for them on the finances yet. But the CTs are getting close to making Hellraiser save. Some tapping on top of Banana, just getting a few holes in the wall and pre-firing all the different spots to clean them up. Angel tries to force the CTs as far back into the side as possible by using his AK as a fearsome weapon. He lost quite a lot of HP, so he has to watch out to not run into any headshots when they start their execution. And his teammates are making their way into apartments and top of middle. So Hellraisers have two different options to make. Either a B go or an A go. And the decision has been made. It's going to be the B execution with 40 seconds on the clock. The CTs have no information yet. They have to dig in deep and they have to stay alive inside the site. But it's not looking too strong of a setup here. With Tugux being out in the open, Engine is the guy to flash and Molotov away to keep the terrorists from pushing all the way through in 23 seconds on the clock. The CTs toss out their last amount of grenades to slow the terrorists down, but it's not gonna slow them down too much. Hugo's now with a big play. Only gets one frag. He's getting traded by Zero. It's a 4v4 already. Spassing Centaurus on the rotation, but he can't help their teammate anymore. The bomb gets dropped by Centaurus through the smoke with 5 seconds on the clock. Can the terrorists even plant it? They will get it done. Zero, the hero, with the last second C4 planned. Hellraiser's in a 3v3 after planned position, and they couldn't get themselves into good, really good positions yet. They have two players at Banana and Questone inside the site. He's making it work with his AK. The double kill is real. And Pass is the only one standing for Space Soldiers. He gets one back, goes for the full spray, and gets a shot onto Questone, making it really expensive for the terrorists. But he doesn't want to challenge Oscar anymore. The round will go the terrorists' favor. But Paz did get those two frags to make it really expensive for Hellraisers, and he's going to save the rifle. So the CTs will have a small fighting chance in this round. They could try and keep the terrorist momentum low. At the same time, they would keep the money low. As you can see yourself, the two frags by Paz made Hellraisers invest so much money in this round. Stiko is the one with the highest amount of cash, 1,500 for him. And the CTs, rightfully so, go for the force buy with a Famous for Tugugs. But this time around, they need to win this round. It's not going to be enough if they do a lot of damage, because the terrorists will face a really easy anti-eco if the CTs can't win this round. Tugugs is kicking it off with the first frag onto Angel, but Questone is quick to reply, drawing it back to equal players on both squads. The CTs rotate Despy into CT spawn, so the A-bomb set has been weakened by that first frag of the terrorists. Xentaris still working together with Pass on A. No one to be seen around there, and Xentaris decides to get a little closer to the B-side in case there is a B-execution. It's not too bad of an idea, but as you can see yourself, the terrorists are making their way into A short. They send Questone around too long, and he gets a frag onto Xentaurus, albeit he's been headshotted himself, so he's low on HP. The CTs have to keep their fingers crossed for Pass to pick up at least two frags in the pit, and he's got the right position to do so. He hasn't been spotted yet, and now Engine is there with the rotation already. Good position by Pass, getting the kill onto Questone. Doesn't get the kill onto Zero, but Despy is there to save the day, and now Stiko pulls it back into 1v1 with Engine and 31 HP. He knows where Stiko is. And Stiko plants the bomb. Engine is already very close by. They dance around the boxes. Nobody gets any damage, and now Stiko is down. Engine with a frag to save Space Soldiers' economy and get them a chance in this first half. Really important round for the CTs, and what an important play by Paz. Even though he only got one frag, he was behind the pillar at first, and he changed his position to be around there, and instead of covering something outside of pit, you know, he was covering pit itself. He was looking at that direction and that direction to keep the terrorists from breaching his position. And that got that frag, that really important frag, to keep the terrorists out of pit. And then the terrorists had to get rid of him. And that allowed Zero to go down to the CTs, to Engine, I believe it was. Picked up that frag at first. And then got the clutch with Pass. Pass played his role, even though he didn't really clutch anything. He played a big role in this round. Hellraisers now on the Deagles with armor. Two Tech Nines. The CTs need some money, so they have to win this round as flawlessly as possible. And they have a good chance in this round. One AK, two Famouses, quite some equipment still. Hellraisers on the other side will go for a full A execution. They want to plant the bomb at all costs. And after that, they want to see where this round is going. Stiko eats an A down to 56. And Despy, in a kind of an off position, makes it work with two frags. Questone came up. Angel came up with a frag, but he got traded. And Pass is still in pit. He's getting covered by Xentaurus. And Space Soldiers win this round with only one casualty. Exactly what I said was going to be true. They win it really comfortably, getting themselves some room for error with 2.7 on two players. They will have a chance to force it up, even if they should lose this round. If they save a few weapons, could still be possible for Space Soldiers to go for a buy. And the terrorists will most likely not force them on that situation. They only have P250s and no armor. First frag is going to be crucial. And Stiko is the go-to guy for that with his Deagle. On the other side we have Questone on top of B. But for now it's just about holding the areas, holding the map control and keep the CTs from getting any information. So you can surprise them at the end of the round. Now Stiko is there, tried to surprise them, didn't get the shot. Despy is going for that peak voluntarily, risks his life, but gets the frag nonetheless. And the terrorists have been spotted, but Despy thinks that it's gonna be a B play, and that's the wrong rotation to make. Xantaris gets spotted by Questone with his pants down, and now it's the CTs coming back again. Thanks to Paz, who picks up two frags. Oscar is the only one standing. He's on long, and he's not long on long, as he got taken down by Despy. 4-4, Space Soldiers get the comeback drone, and now we have another rifle round, and this is going to determine where this game can go. Will it be Space Soldiers getting away from Hellraisers, or is the CIS squad clawing their way into that terrorist side again? Oscar already out. That's the AWP gone. Angel takes it back. And I think they thought about switching weapons there for a second. Didn't happen, however. Hellraiser still spread out. Two players working in apartments and two on top of Banana. The CTs go for the default playing style. The 2-3 split. Couldn't be more default by Space Soldiers. But on the other side, Hellraisers haven't really forced them to adjust themselves to anything, because Hellraisers played rather default as well. They try to wait for the CTs to make a mistake, and if there is a mistake, they try to figure out how to capitalize on that advantage they got themselves. And if there is nothing happening, Hellraisers simply go for the full execution. And they don't really have anything cheeky going on. Now Stiko is going for something more cheeky. He tries to fake the A-bomb side go. Makes his presence known over there. Flashes back again. And the CTs are kept on A quite long. No rotation yet. Tugux is already molotoving away. But so are the terrorists. And he steps in the flames into the bullets of Questone. Engine going big. And his teammates are already rotating in there. He already got himself two frags. And he's allowed to reload his weapon. Questone with the frag in the end to make it a 2v2 as Stiko is alone. The bomb is not ticking. 2 seconds on the clock. The CTs have won the round thanks to Xantaris' frag on the bomb planter. Questone tried to get it done, but Xantaris got that frag, intercepted the bomb from going down, and Space Soldiers win yet another round, 5-4. This time it was a little closer than before. Even though Oscar was down at the very start of the round, Hellraisers got it back and almost won it. Hellraisers go for the force buy, something that they are well known for. And Stiko gets rid of Xantaris. Now the CTs end up in some trouble, especially as Pass goes down. The terrorists try to get their hands on some weaponry. Angel and company push through to A long. They have an M4A 4-4 Angel, but no armor on him. Oscar picked up an orb and got the frag onto Despy at the same time. Tugux and Engine on the rotation, but they know that Angel is around the library somewhere, reading the Art of War. While Oscar is reading the Art of Orb playing to Tugux. And as Engine went for the bombsite, Angel got him backstabbed. 5-5, Hellraisers win that force buy with one weapon for Stiko, one AK, and the right timing on top of middle. They waited for the CTs to toss a smoke, and Stiko stepped through it and caught Xantaris out in the open, got that frag, and that was the cue for Hellraisers. They quickly capitalized on that small advantage they got themselves. And with Paz going down on A long, Hellraisers knew there was only one more player on the A side, so they just simply pushed in there. Now they will push into the B bomb side with their two opening frags thanks to Angel's AK spray. The CTs with the AWP on Despy. 5-7 on Paz and Xantaris. And they want to save that AWP, they want to save their armor as well. Paz gets a frag onto Stiko. And Xantaris and him will take refuge in apartments. Now the CTs have some good positions over there. But Paz needs to watch out. He's down to 7 HP, so he separates himself from the pack. He goes for a solo play now. Just wants to stay hidden. While Xantaris gets himself another frag onto Zero. Good job by him. Flashing out to get his hands on the AK. And the CTs have salvaged two more weapons by the terrorists. Or from the terrorists, rather. Hellraisers need to watch out to not make this too costly. And they won't challenge the CTs anymore, so Space Soldiers make that eco round kind of a, not a save round, but a shopping round. They went to the mall, they got themselves some kills over there, and they just, you know, got the shopping bags of all the normal people in the shopping mall, filled with AKs and some other features. Angel tries to punish them for that shopping spree by getting himself into top of banana. Three CTs over there. Tugux and Despy get tagged a little bit. Angel is still alive, but Despy gets rid of Questone, and another nade will rain on Angel. Good triple nading off top of banana. They get that frag and make it a 5v3 already. Zero is in apartments pushing forward. They don't really have a different or another chance, another option than to go for the A side. Stiko with a good headshot onto Xantaris, and Stiko goes down to pass. Despy with a quick rotation into library got it back to a 3v2, and now Zero is stepping in with the balcony spray. He's making it a 1v2 with two headshots. Tugux and Engine, the last man alive for the CTs, and Tugux only has a 5-7. As I speak, he picks up the AWP. And Engine goes for an AWP as well. Now he drops it again for the Famous. Tugux doesn't know that Zero is coming around. Good clutch by Zero so far. Can he take it? Can he win the round? The smoke will not be positioned correctly for Engine. And Zero knows there is a small gap. Oh, if Engine had only pulled through on the defuse, he could have made it. Now Zero is just stepping away to scare Engine, and it works perfectly, but Engine gets a frag nonetheless. The bomb is ticking quite fast already. Will he make it? It seems like he does. He will make it out in just in time, as the bomb was about to flash yellow, or white rather. Space Soldiers win the round and make it 6-6. Another crucial clutch by Engine. 17 frags for Despy, 10 for Paz. On the other side, we have 11 for Questone and 11 for Angel. Oscar had a really rough time so far. He had the AWP quite a few times, but most often than not, he did go down as the first player. So he couldn't get himself into a position where he can get one or two frags, because he was down at the very start of a round. And that kept him from getting kills altogether. The terrorists will try to get some frags on the A side, but Paz breaks them all down. Three headshots and one normal kill. But that's definitely enough for him. Perfect angle to spray into apartments. Everyone had to pass his bullets twice, because they came around that corner, and you will be sprayed at first over here. Then you have to run around that corner, and you will be sprayed again. So it worked out perfectly for Space Soldiers in that situation. Two more rounds in the half. And Hellraisers with another force buy. They go for the AK for Oscar. Maybe he can finally do something and help his teammates out. Razor's poke into the A-bomb site. They have Questone taking point with his Deagle. But he couldn't hit a single shot on the Arch player. Space Odors play it very defensively. Now they know there is some action on A, so they pull four players together. But Oscar gets a header onto Despy, making it a 4v5. Paz retaliates onto Questone. And Angel is forced to help his teammates on the execution as they lose that one man. They know the force is not strong enough in them. Zero gets Molotov away from his position as well. And the terrorists are just waiting for that equipment to fade away from the CT so they can finally do something about this round. Engine is still at B and Tugux goes for a B rotation that leaves only two players at A with Xantaris and Paz. They have to defend themselves. They will be surrounded by the terrorists. Xantaris with one, Oscar with the trade. And now Paz is taken out by Oscar as well. A quick movement of the wrist and that's another one gone. 3v2 in favor of the terrorists who couldn't get themselves weapons yet. So many weapons lying on the floor, but they couldn't pick up a single one of them. Now Oscar knows where Tugux is. He gets rid of him with that AK spray. Turns around just to be killed by Engine. It's a 1v2 in favor of the terrorists still. They have that crossfire with a P250 in the apartments. And Stiko playing the Deagle inside the site. Engine prepares the clutch. But he gets pushed by Zero and Stiko at the same time. Hellraisers win that force by. And Space Soldiers seem to be a little gutted. They could have made it 9-6. But now it's a 7-7. And a possible 8-7 for Hellraisers even. The CTs go for some information in the middle, but Despy gets flashed before he gets around the corner. So it's only Xantaris going for a small peek, showing that he's only got a Deagle. Maybe trying to make the terrorists believe that it's an even weaker buy than the CTs already have. It is a weak buy by Space Soldiers. No arguing about that, with a CZ-75 and a Deagle for Engine and Xantaris. But they also have three rifles. And it highly depends on where the terrorists will go. Hellraisers cleaning apartments with Zero and Stiko. On the other side of the map, they are also gaining some ground on top of Bananas, so they have the choice to make. And it seems like they want to go for the B site. Even though Space Soldiers might have stacked one of the two sites, Hellraisers still want to go in there without getting too much information. Oscar's looking in there. Doesn't see anyone yet. And Engine is very close by with a CZ-75. Really dangerous for the terrorists. If he doesn't get spotted, could do some massive amount of damage, and he doesn't get spotted by the first one, but Questone is there, and maybe took his time too long. Xantaris and Tugux though chime in with the two frags, make it a 3v3, as Zero got rid of Tugux inside the B-bomb site. The bomb is being planted, the smoke is still in position, and he gets re-smoked on top of that, so the CTs have to come around construction site where Angel is holding. He's holding not anymore, but Oscar is there to reinforce the position. He's got the AWP ready. It's a 1v1 though. Despy is taken out by Oscar. A 1v2 clutch for him, just making it look easy to get to 10 frags when he was down at 3 for the majority of the half. Suddenly Oscar stepped up, and that's when Hellraisers gained those last few rounds and made it 8-7. Space Soldiers could have won a few more rounds. I will show you exactly what I mean. The terrorists got themselves... No. That's the terrorist graph. So the terrorists got themselves this round here. Because, you know, Questone was on the terrorist side. So the blue graph is the real graph. Doesn't matter, I will walk you through that later on, because Angel is already kicking off the fragging on top of Banana with a good headshot on the first few terrorists coming his way. Now there is some more action. Three CTs against two terrorists. Space Soldiers really need to win this fight if they want to get this round, or they need to avoid that fight altogether. Questone retaliates onto Engine, and Oscar shuts down Despy in Boiler Room, making it a 1v4. engine and pass try to work together. They have a Molotov to clean up pit. And Despy cleans up apartments with a frag onto Oscar. Now they're racing down A Shaw. They spot Stiko inside the pit. And they want to push him together, but both of them fail some jumps, but they don't fail to get the frag. Pass gets rid of Stiko with a headshot. Now he gets another one onto Questone, and Zero is sadly for himself. He's left alone, but both of the terrorists are low on HP with 15 and 5. Zero is taking his time. He waits for the terrorists to get that bomb planted, but it is still in pit. Now he gets spotted by Pass. He's getting pushed by both of the terrorists. Good teamwork by them. They got the bomb over to the side. And Zero has to work his way back into the round with his 3 HP. He's got the USP, but he can't get any shots off onto any of the two terrorists. And Engine will win this round. Space Soldiers work their way back into a 2v5. And they won it with Engine and Pass coming up big, especially Paz is doing a lot of work for Space Soldiers tonight. That pit push was really important. He got caught on that railing for a second, and I thought, okay, he will probably die now, but he didn't. In fact, he got two more frags from that position. The CT's on the Deagle Force. Xenteris already disposes of the first one. Second easy kill for Xenteris. And the B-bomb set has been opened up completely. Xenteris just need to push through. They have the smoke in there. And Angel could stop them with his Deagle, but he needs to get some heads. Doesn't do that. Xenteris with superior aim onto Angel, making it a 2v5. Stiko and Oscar left alone. Stiko is in CT spawn. Not anymore as Despy comes in with his UMP. And Oscar is in construction site with a P2000. Maybe he can get his hands on a weapon and some money. But Tuguk sprays him down with the MP7. 9-8 in favor of Space Soldiers. They win the pistol and they do the mandatory. They win that save round. And it's the CTs on a naked save. Space Soldiers should make it 10-8. Oh, good Molotov on the CTs, forcing them out of position, drawing them way back into the B-bomb site. The top of Banana has been captured. Tuguk takes a peek in there. Thinks about smoking off CT spawn. He won't be challenged while he throws that smoke. Gets Xenteris into position to push through. And together they methodically work their way into the bomb site. Now it's Tuguk taking the peek. They will re-smoke CT spawn. Working together in quite some good fashion. Xenteris spots the shoulder of Angel. He expects somebody to be around that box. Just checks the corners and now he gets a frag. A third one for Xenteris. Another anti-eco triple kill for him. Stiko and Oscar, the last man alive. Stiko is now on his own. Tuguk desperately gets or tries to get his Deagle to work on Stiko, but didn't hit a single shot. But Engine does. 10-8 for Space Soldiers. 21 kills on Despy. 18 for Paz, 17 for Xenteris. And Space Soldiers up against the first rear rifle round by Hellraisers. Orb for Oscar. Of course, he's got the orb. Otherwise, it would be quite a waste. Angel and company will open up this round with some deep banana control, some apartment control play as well. So they don't give the terrorists any room to breathe in. They suffocate them at the start of the round, leaving Engine and Xenteris alone. Xenteris is taken out by Oscar's orb. And Engine is on his own in this rifle round. No hope for him. He's already... Oh, he wasn't spotted by Stiko. Now he is. Stiku was surprised a little bit. Engine picks the fight and goes down for that M4A4 spray down to the max. Hellraisers with the 9th round on the board and Space Soldiers with the next rifle round. They need to stop the CTs from getting more money and more momentum. As you can see yourself, Hellraisers already saved up enough money to sustain a round loss in this round. So, Space Soldiers need to win 2 rounds in a row to force the Hellraiser squad on a save. And that doesn't necessarily make their job any easier. Since the first smoke failed, as you can see over here on the screen, on top of the roof, it would be so cool if you could draw in the game as a spectator. Like you can draw on the map, but you can draw on the normal screen. I mean, on this screen that we have. So I could point out that Oscar is standing on the left, and there are 2 players in apartments working their way forward. While the CTs have 2 in pit and a 3-man rotation at the B bomb site. Not looking good for Hellraisers. Coming up with quite the wrong call to make. Space Soldiers are completely stacked up on the A side. Oscar and Angel could go for a backstab. But it's gonna be risky. No matter what. Despy gives away his position on top of middle with that AWP shots. With those AWP shots. And now Space Soldiers quickly line up those smokes. And as I said, Angel and Oscar are coming in from the back. Look at them, they're just waiting for the terrorists to make their move, and then they will get in there from all the chaos. Angel capitalizes with a double kill in top of middle. The terrorists have no other way than to push forward. And as they push forward, they go down one by one. Paz is left on his own with 12 seconds on the clock. And Hellraisers played that round perfectly. It was a small risk involved there. But Space Soldiers sadly took their time on that execution, and thus they ended up being backstabbed by Angel and Oscar. Angel was the one to open up, and if he had gone down, Oscar would have been there to retaliate. The terrorists have to save now, and Hellraisers can use that chance to build up more economy. Something that I pointed out at the very start of this game, if the CTs get their economies kick-started, it's so amazingly hard for the terrorists to get themselves any map control and to make those executions work. And even if they get 1 round on the board, or maybe even 2 in a round, 2 in a row, the CTs would still have enough money to buy up straight away and stop the terrorists from getting the real momentum going. Now that's a good frag by Xenteras onto Oscar. He picks up the orb as well. But the CTs have 0 in their cheeky position. He's still around and he gets himself 3 frags in a row. Leaving Despy on his own. Can try and save that orb maybe. But I think it's not really necessary. Picks off 0, who overextended a little bit. And Despy still has a chance if he picks off Questone. Just didn't get the shot off, and now Questone has him pinned down with 14 HP. No real chance for Despy anymore. Hellraisers make it 11-10 with 3 rounds in a row, capitalizing on the first rifle they won. Getting a little cheeky as well with that backstab by Angel and Oscar. So the terrorists need to be wary of that position at all times. If they want to go for an A execution, they have to have somebody covering their back on bottom of banana. And that will weaken their A execution. It will also make them worried a little bit. And if you make the terrorists worry about their own positions, like, they are, so to speak, they are defending themselves. At the same time, they're trying to attack something else. So, it always stays in the back of their heads. And it makes them less focused on the important tasks. Xenteras already sprayed down to 10 HP through the smoke by Angel. And Hellraisers like the deep banana control, and it's working out perfectly for them. They only have Angel over there. And that's good, but at the same time it's risky as well. If the terrorists gather that information. They can let the smoke pop, they can let Angel get close, and then they could try and smoke them, flash themselves through the smoke. Not really needed at the moment, as Paz got himself two frags on top of middle. Stiko pulling it back with his own double kill, making it a 3v3 again. And the terrorists will be slowed down enough for the CTs to reposition themselves. Angel expects the terrorists to swing back to Banana. And it seems like that's the plan. But as you can see, they are moving so slowly because they think that Angel could be around any corner. And that wastes so much time. The CTs will easily rotate Oscar in CT spawn already, so he can support either side as quickly as he can. Angel has to get one frag at least, and that should be enough for the round to go the way of Hellraisers with 4 seconds on the clock. The Terrorist barely planned the bomb in time. Now Xenteris steps in with his 10 HP. He gets that shot onto Angel, draws it back to a 2v2. And Oscar is still alone on construction site. He picks off Xenteris and makes it a 1v2 in the CT's favor. And he even gets a kill onto Tugux, who had the initiative in that fight. But Hellraisers will still make it 12-10 against Space Soldiers, the heavy favorites on any betting site. Let's check the odds. 64% in favor of Hellraisers and 36% for Space Soldiers. Let's check EGB.com, one of our trusty partners, real quick. We have to focus on this weapon round as well, as it's gonna be important. And Xenteris turns his back towards middle. They know that Oscar is around with an orb. I don't know why would you show your backside like that. Tugux and company will lose yet another man to Stiko in apartments, and he smokes himself out of there as well. So the terrorist left with a two-man disadvantage, no map control, and no idea where to go. And the odds on EGB.com are 1.3 in favor of Hellraisers and 2.6 in favor of Space Soldiers. So Hellraisers are the clear favorites, if you ask the community. And I already told you that Space Soldiers can give Hellraisers a run for their money, but they need everyone to be on the same page. They have three players performing quite well, but Engine and Tugux are falling off quite hard with 9 and 5 frags only in 23 rounds. On the other side, we have Angel with 20-17 for Oscar, who definitely came alive at the end of the first half here. Can show you his total kills, as we have a pause anyway. Look at that, he was sitting at 3 kills. And then he picked up 7 frags in 2 rounds. Winning 2 rounds for the terrorists. And getting them ahead. Giving them a really easy time here. And in this half, he got himself 7 frags already. That's almost as many frags as he got in a complete first half, where he was sitting at 1 frag until the 9th round. So, let's talk about the equipment value. A big part or a big role was the anti-eco or the eco round upsets that the CTs, Hellraisers, managed to pull on the terrorist side. So, they were on the terrorist side, but their graphs are blue in the first half, whereas the rounds they won are yellow, so you have to keep your eyes on that one. They won this save round, and they won this save round. And this one was the round where Oscar picked up 4 kills. So key rounds that gave them 2 in a row, and ultimately made it possible for them to get to 8 rounds in the first half. But I like Space Soldier's tactical pause now. They really need to figure out what to do. I think they have gathered enough information in the previous few rounds, so they can tell each other what is going on the other side. Like, the Banana player can tell his apartment guys, okay guys, when we go through Banana, we have this and that problem. I need you or I need two guys over here to help me flash myself through the smoke, then we can get a frag over there, we can get a foothold on top of Banana, push the CTs back into more defensive positions over here and here, or possibly even here, and if we smoke off CT spawn, we should get a B execution going. Or something like, well, guys, we have Steeko in bedroom sometimes, we have somebody on top of Banana, and we have somebody in pit all the time, let's do this and that so we can get rid of them as easily as possible. And of course they have to keep in mind Oscar is sitting in that area quite a lot, and if he has that deep peek and if he gets a frag on the terrace over here, it will give Hellraiser such an easy time in the rounds if they start off in the first 20 seconds with a frag in their back. It makes it so much easier for the CTs to maintain map control. They can send Angel down there. They can afford to lose a guy going for information. They can afford to set somebody up here in apartments or in boiler room or somewhere else. And it doesn't matter too much for them, because even if that guy gets killed, it's still a 4v4. And if he gets killed, he usually at least spots the terrace, for example. If they go this way, he will spot them over here, he can call it out, and the CTs can go for a quick rotation and keep the B-bomb set under control, for example. So let's see what Space Raiders are coming up with. It seems like they focus on Banana for now, but the CTs have predicted that move already. Some good counters by them, the smoke is already deployed. We have some incendiary nades behind the smoke as well, so the terrorists can't even push through the smoke. Like I said, that would have been a possibility for Space Soldiers. So the Turkish squad has to keep their horses tied down a little bit. Now, unfortunate smoke there. It's completely impossible to use the smoke in that way. I hope we can show you that at the end of the round. Centaurus is still looking for the frag. He does pick it up onto Oscar. That's the important first frag for the terrorists. Now the CTs are, well, they are on the back foot, let's call it like that. Because they are not really out of control, but they are weakened on both sides. And they decide to go for some information. Steeko and Questone, Zero, are looking at a short. And the T's could go for a B split even. The CTs try to prevent that from happening with Questone setting back into CT spawn, so he keeps Angel's back clean. And the terrorists are fed up with all the shenanigans. Let's keep it simple and clean, and it's not gonna be simple. It's not gonna be clean at all. It's gonna be a 1v3 in favor of the CTs. Tuguk's already down to 5 HP and the time running out as well. Space Soldiers have wasted that chance with that 4 spy, and Hellraisers make it 14-10. Only 2 more rounds to go for Hellraisers, and they have managed to win that first best of 1 in the Go Champions League Season 3. Presented to you by G2A, EGB.com, Twitch, and SteelSeries. There is with yet another 4 spy, almost no nades for them. They have to go in there barefooted, and Tuguk's eats a full nade down to 45 HP, while Angel sets up his position on top of the car. Terra is patiently waiting for the smoke to fade, but it gets re-smoked. And Angel lines up that first frag onto Xantaras. That's the biggest impact player for Space Soldiers gone already. His teammates have to step in. Pass is the go-to guy at the moment. He did so much work on the CT side. Maybe he can pull it off on the terrorist side. He is sent in as the first guy. And his teammates are still nowhere near him. He has to watch out to not go down, and the CTs will smoke him off, leaving no other options than the A side for the terrorist. Engine with a cheeky frag onto Oscar. Catches him off guard. Zero goes down to 34 with a second spray by Engine. Good job by him getting as far as that position on the truck. Has to reload eventually, and Zero picks him off for that. 3v3. The CTs with a two-man rotation. Angel having some trouble against Despy, and the terrorist will finish him off with a headshot, leaving Zero on his own inside the bombsite, and he's getting pushed by Pass. Finally, Spacer is in control of the A side, and they will get the bomb planted. Questone has enough money on the bank to make that try, but I don't know if he really wants to go for it. Maybe he could try and get his hands on the AWP that Oscar has dropped. But the terrorists are a little bit too close, and now Despy has snatched the AWP from middle. So Questone can't do anything anymore. He has to save now, and Hellraisers will not get the match point right away. Cheeky little frag there by Questone. Spacesuiters avoid the match point situation for Hellraisers. The Turkish squad with some more room to work with. Engine with really important frags here. He was sitting at 9. He got 2 frags in this round. And he did win that round for Spacesuiters in a way. He wasn't alone, of course, but he played a big role. Angel onto 2 gooks. That's the opening the openings that Hellraisers want to get, and it seems to be a little bit too easy for them to get that frag and then get out of there as well. That's Oscar pinning down Xenteris in middle. Xenteris knew exactly what was going to happen. His plan was to shoot his opponent, though. Another frag by Oscar. He gets traded by Engine, but Oscar is still alive. And that's the triple kill for him. He leg shots Despy as well. Despy with the retaliation, making it a 1v3 with 1 minute on the clock. The CTs need to watch out to not mess up over here. And we will reconnect to the server just because it's cool and edgy. I can't switch to Despy. Now I can. So the CTs need to watch out. In a 3v1 on Inferno, if you give him a chance to plant the bomb, you can really quickly run into some trouble. Zero went out into apartments and repositioned himself at the balcony just to be safe and just to be alive when the bomb goes down, and then go for a re-rotation, or if it had been planted or would be planted on A, Zero would be close and he could intercept the bomb from going through. Despy's taking his time, checking every single corner with 10 seconds on the clock. He doesn't have enough time anymore and he has to go for the plant. Angel's around the corner and that's an easy frag for him. Hellraisers make it 15-11. And Angel was caught changing his weapon. Ended up with no rifle at all. That's a small bummer for him. But he gets a drop by his teammate, so no worries for the CTs. On the other side, we have Despy and company on Tech-9s and the Galil. Despy is going to be the go-to guy. They try to counter the CT's early aggression in Banana, but it doesn't really work out so far. Suddenly, the CT's coming with the frags. All of a sudden, it's a 1v4 already. Xenteris is on his own. Everyone got a piece of the cake. Oscar with the double. Stiko is calling it a GG already, but it's Xenteris. Well, not anymore. 16-11. Good performance by Angel and company. Spacers did give a good account of themselves, but it wasn't enough for them. Ultimately, they fell short against Hellraisers, who proceed to the winner's game. And we will see their opponent being, found out between Penta and VWS, a squad from Lithuania, Slovakia, and Poland. I hope that you will stay with me. Thank you for tuning in so far. Disable your adblocker if you want to support me and the Goat Champions League. And other than that, stick around for some more Goat Champions League action. Thank you from my side.